Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another episode. Thank y'all for tuning in. We are dead smack in the middle of winter. Got a few cold fronts come in, had some deep freezes, dropped those water temperatures. So we're out today looking for some speckled trout. We're gonna fish a little bit shallow, look for those big girls, look for those 20, 25 inch trout. Probably fish a little bit deeper water as well, so we can find any on there. But either way, we're gonna get on to some fish. So thank y'all for watching. Stay tuned. There we go. There we go. That's a nice trout, nice trout. There we go, yes sir. Ooh. Twenty-three and a half. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Nice. Way to start off the morning. Cool. Check that out. Beautiful girl. Beautiful girl. There you go. There we go. There it is. Got him. Got him. That's a nice trout. There we go. That's a nice trout right there. Cool. There we go. See what we're looking at. Cool. 19 inch trout. Nice. Beautiful trout. Just throwing them in those little pockets where we're finding those mullet jumping. Able to pick off trout here and there. They're not too cold. We got a cold front yesterday, lowered the air temperatures, but that water temperature is still warm, still about the 60s, so we're still good, still good. There we go. There we go, got another one. Oh, damn it, that sucker came off. There we go, got another one. Got him. Oh, no. What the heck is this? Little redfish. Little redfish. Cool. On that jerk shad, that salt strong jerk shad. Cool. Oh, there we go. There's another one I wasn't even looking. That's a nice trout right there.
Here we go. Cool, not a huge one, but. Not a big one, maybe about a 17, 18 inch trout. Cool. There we go. Ah, sucker came off. And so the area that we're looking for is just basically these shallow flats. They're just shallow sandy flats, and then they'll just drop off to about 5-6 feet of water. I mean, we're in the main part of the bay. A lot of these back bays are muddier. They have some trout, have some bigger fish, but we've had a bit of a cold snap. We've had a couple of deep freezes, and it seems like they kind of pulled all those fish out of those back bays. So we're kind of here near the main part of the bay, fishing those flats, fishing those deeper drop-offs, and that's what's been working this winter. That's all we've been doing. We've just been throwing some soft plastics. The lure that we've been using is this Salt Strong Jerk Shad. I made another video the other day when we first tried it out. Had really good things to say about it. Caught a whole bunch of fish. So I'll put that link in the description. But this is what we're using today. This is what's been working. We're just letting it sink to the bottom. Those fish are kind of sitting near the bottom, waiting around. Once we get it down to the bottom, we're just giving it a few jerks, just a little pop, pop, and let it go back down. Another little pop, pop. Maybe only moving in about 1, maybe 2 feet, as opposed to just, you know, 3-4 feet with the rod tip. So that's all what we've been doing, keeping it close to the bottom, looking for that concentration of mullet, and that's what's been working. That's what we've been doing all winter. All right, so all we're doing is we're just looking for that mullet. I mean, as simple as it sounds, the water's still pretty warm. We got a cold front in yesterday. Air temperature is a little bit cooler, but that water temperature is still pretty warm. It's going to take a little bit for that to cool down. There's still mullet jumping around. There's still mullet about, there's one right there. They're still mulling about 3-5 feet of water. So looking for the mullet, but I'm looking for more of the high concentration of mullet. You can see where there's a bigger school, you'll just see 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, jumping in the same area, as opposed to maybe one here, one there, one over here. That's basically all I'm doing, just looking for that higher concentration of mullet, staying in that area, making as many casts as I can. And we've been pulling some trout out. That wind's picking up. I don't think it's supposed to get much more windier, but still, just gotta fight that wind just to keep my position. Of course it wasn't recording, but we just moved to another spot, a few yards down to another rock pile, and first cast ended up getting this fish. Nice trout. Some nice trout right there. All right, oh, flip. Come on, come on. There we go. That's a nice trout right there. Oh, oh, oh. All right, let's get a measurement on this one. Let's see what he is. Pretty trout. Inch trout. So that's a pretty trout right there. Cool. See, the other guys that I was catching closer to shore were a lot warmer. This guy's still his body. He's cold. Pretty trout. All right, let's let this guy go. Yeah, that wind's kicking up. It's getting a little breezy. You can start seeing all the white caps and stuff from the waves. Most of the fishermen already left, but sometimes this is the time when the fish start biting. Gotta be careful. Just gotta know what you're doing and know your limits when that wind starts picking up. So I marked that spot, so let's go back to it. Those little rock pile right there, that's where we've been catching two in a row. So we moved a little bit closer to shore, kept getting pushed off the rocks, had a hard time holding the position. Bite kind of died down as well, so we'll try a little bit closer to shore just for a few minutes, and then if not, we'll head back in, we'll pack it up. I mean, it's already almost noon and we did pretty good. If I'm not mistaken, I think we got a limit of speckled trout. So all in all, I think it was a good day. There we go. Got him. God damn, that's that area that the mullet were jumping. There was a few mullet jumping here and there. Not a big one. Not a big one. Oh, this guy's cold. Oh, just pee. There's just pee everywhere. Not a big guy. Little one. But that's where those mullet were at. Like I said, just find the mullet. Find those higher concentration of mullet and fish a little bit slower because it is wintertime. Those fish are going to be sitting at the bottom. Not going to be all too active, but they're still going to bite. They still got to eat.